You ask what is right and what does good. What achieves good? And then you have to define your good. There are different goods. On the economic issue, the right wants prosperity and the left wants equality. So you have to choose. In light of that, do we have the Vanden Heuvel clip there? This woman who's, what was she on, CNN? What was she on? She was on This Week on ABC? She writes for The Nation. Left of The Nation is the... What is Left of The Nation? I guess the Pyongyang Daily. I mean it. I don't know what it's like. I can't name anything Left of The Nation. I mean, The Nation would acknowledge they're leftist. The New York Times calls The Nation liberal, which shows you how liberalism has been vanquished by leftism. The greatest disaster philosophically in our lifetime. The death of liberalism as leftism took it over. Anyway, she was on... This week, and I'm talking to you about this equality issue. That's what the left wants, less prosperity. Prosperity doesn't jingle their jangle. What jingles the leftist's jangle is equality. Listen.
Regular people. And elitist and kind of but snooty.
To pick up on what Cokie says, I think these discussions about Bill Maher and the Hillary Rosen and Romney, much of that plays into a view that our politics are failing to deal with the massive deep-seated problems this country has, whether it's how do you send your kid to college, or how do you not get evicted from your home, or why do we have inequality akin to Egypt's. I think that's...
Why do we have inequality akin to Egypt? Whoa! Did you know that? I'm talking about people under the poverty line, live like the poor in Egypt. 3, 4, no, not percent. I mean 3 or 4. Inequality like that of Egypt. See, for the left, I'm not saying this for every single individual who has a leftist view. There are liars on the right and liars on the left, but for the left, truth is not a value. Compassion is a value, equality is a value, progress is a value, change is a value, but truth is not. Because if truth stands in the way, then you just don't tell it. Tell me why that is not a lie, that we have inequality, that we have the same inequality in the United States like that of Egypt. Tell me what would you call it, an exaggeration, hyperbole? And, of course, it goes unchallenged. It just mouths off this thing. Textbooks now in high school, which you don't take student loans for, although some might. Textbooks in California are no longer even, they don't even pretend to give you history in history text. The purpose of a textbook in California, and it's important because California, by virtue of its being the most populous state, orders the most textbooks, so they influence textbooks for everybody. Now, the textbook is no longer a vehicle to history. It is a vehicle to self-esteem and for political correctness, which is, of course, a definition of that which the left finds appropriate or inappropriate. So now in California, there has to be, must be by law. It is a law, or the text cannot be sold in California to a school. And the law is that it must have gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgendered contributions to American history and California history. So the purpose is not truth. It's never been for the left. Because if the truth, and I give an example in my book coming out next Tuesday, which I pray you read. I don't know what to say. I sell others' things better than my own. But it's my life's work, and I show how they deal with these issues, wherein the manipulation of facts to make people feel good. The purpose is to feel good, whatever group you are in. So we have these laws now with these texts on the contributions that these groups make. And what exactly are they? I mean, what is the transgendered contribution that is greater than others, that it has to be highlighted? But it infects everything. Example I give in the book is the list of the great composers, the 10 greatest composers who ever lived, and the New York Times music critic said, I would put Haydn in the list, except I can't put in too many Viennese composers who lived around that time. So there's affirmative action in everything. He admitted, I'm not giving you the list of the best 10 composers is not about the 10 best composers, because the 10 best composers would be overly Austrian / German living at a certain time, and that's not diverse enough. Get it? So it's not the 10 best. Best doesn't mean anything, even in culture, for the folks poisoned by leftism. Leftism is an intellectual poison. So, after all, so they have to put in Stravinsky. There you go. There you got a 20th century guy, different nationality, and everybody's happy. Is he better than Haydn? No, nobody thinks he is. Or Debussy, right? We didn't have any French composers, and that's not fair. That's not fair. I mean, for that matter, well, I don't know why they didn't put in Grieg. There were no Norwegians on the list. And, not to mention nobody east of Russia, no Asians. So excellence doesn't matter either.